In this video, I'll go over the basics of UI in Godot. You can make a UI out of practically anything, but we'll focus on the control nodes here. UI in Godot is based on bounding boxes. Every control node has a minimum size, just like how every 2D node has a position. There are two options to position the element, anchor and container. Let's look at anchor, where the element decides for itself. You can find it at the top of the tab to the left of the anchor icon or under Layout Anchor Preset. Let's pick Full and then change it to Custom. Now look under Anchor Points. Anchor is relative to the Parents box, where the top and left are 0, bottom and right are 1. If I make the left anchor point 0.5, it'll take the right half of the Parents box. Anchor Offset, however, is absolute. But sometimes the box we got from anchors is smaller than the actual content in there, so where does the extra bit go? That is decided by grow direction. When the element is found under a container node, it's the parent to decide. By default, the element takes as little space as possible. But it can tell the parent that it wants all of the available space by turning on expand. All children with expand will share the available space equally, unless one is a bully and decides to push outwards with twice the force. This one takes 2/3 of the available space. This is configured by stretch ratio. Now that the parent has given the child a certain space, the child needs to decide how it wants to use that space. By picking fill, it takes all the space given. With the three shrink options, however, it gets squeezed. Shrink begin squeezes backward, shrink end squeezes forward, and shrink center will shrink towards the center. Now that you know how to make a menu, how do we overlay another menu on top? For that, you need canvas layer. Notice the layer property. The higher number renders on top of the lower, regardless of spawning order. To use these UI, you can use your mouse, or like in many games, just keyboard and controller. So the focus options deal with where the focus should move to. You wouldn't need to configure this for the container children, since the container already did the job. Maybe you'd like to provide a shortcut, a hotkey, for a commonly used button. To do that, create a button, go to shortcut, make a new shortcut, and add an input event. I'm gonna demonstrate input event key here. Click on configure, and then press the key that you want to set it to. Now you find three options: key code, physical, and key label. Key code is where the button on a QWERTY keyboard gives you S, but on a Dvorak, it would give you O instead. It depends on the keyboard. Now, physical is the position of this keyboard button in reference to a QWERTY keyboard. Key label is the actual Unicode glyph being typed in. If you use a Cyrillic keyboard, that button gives you U. Oh, and by the way, don't ask me why I know Cyrillic. These diagrams that you saw in the video are made by me, including these two that weren't shown in the video. If you want to download them, you can head over to the link below. Oh, you like that funky font in the diagrams? That's actually made by me as well, and you can find it on my itch page. This has been Josiah. Have fun, make games.